here. Welcome to this desert part of the country. My esteemed Honorable Justice Madam Vandana sir, Professor G.S. Kulkarni, Shri Mukhtarji, my BBA President, Bikaner Bar Association, Dr. Moot Jain, eminent lady judges sitting here, who would be the judges for the various rounds, faculty members, ladies and gentlemen. I'm delighted to be with you all this morning in the third Seth Jagannath Bajaj Memorial Nation Moot Court competition being organized under the very dynamic leadership of Professor Karkarasa, who has been so active and vibrant, and whenever I see him meeting, I also energize myself because he has lot of energy with him and he passes on such energy to one who meets him. Well, friends, I need not impress upon what is Moot Court, but over the years it has gained popularity, particularly whenever this five-year courses were introduced. From then onwards, because it gives you a practical insight of the court atmosphere. It has gained ground throughout the country, and I am happy that students, especially coming out of passing out five-year course, that's my practical experience when I was a judge. Students passing out of 5-year course are doing exceedingly well. All credit goes to the NGOs and other institutions who introduced 5-year course. Like they say, so a pass out of 5-year course within 3 years, does exceedingly well as against an advocate practicing over 2 decades. That is my personal experience. All credit goes to my young students who are thorough, well prepared, and is ready with the facts and law. Well, students, you have chosen the right path, as you would be entering the noble profession of law, serving the society in a divine manner. Law or justice, as it is known, still commands respect as against all other 3 pillars of the Constitution. Even the leaders are afraid of jurisdictions. They are afraid only of one organ, that is judicial side. Otherwise, what is happening in the country, you all know. Everywhere there is an atmosphere of fear, anarchy. But judges come to the rescue of needy and downtrodden, and that is a fine balance which is maintained by in the constitution. It is truly sad that if anything good is happening in this country, that is because of judiciary alone. By and large, people of this great country have reposed full faith in the judiciary, and even in remote corners of the country, far and wide, if something happens, the people say it is not because of the courts granting justice. Especially to the millions who have not been able to get their due despite 70 years of independence. Out of the three pillars of an Indian democracy, judiciary, legislature, and executive, the judiciary has assumed a great role. Judging by its role through decades, the Supreme Court, the highest judiciary organization of this great country, has not only made sure the extension of democracy to the weaker sections of the country, but also saved democracy from relapsing into authoritarian tendencies. The Supreme Court has emerged as a savior of the Indian Constitution. As you all know, the Indian Constitution, which we are bound, is one of the finest constitutions in the world. When it was made, it took into consideration several constitutions of the various countries, and I appreciate the founding fathers which gave into us this constitution. And even of the students, and rather everyone should be, to imbibe the preamble and the constitutional values as we are all governed by it. Friends, let me ask you one question. Ashok chakra, jo ek hamara rashtriya stambh hai, how many of you know ki what are the special features in it, what it depicts, what it shows? Can any student, because we are all learned, we are learning, can anyone of this student say कि उसमें क्या क्या होते हैं, क्या क्या फीचर हैं, क्या क्या चिन्ह है, उसके क्या व्हाट इट डिपिक्ट्स? कम ऑन कम ऑन यस 24 लाइंस व्हाट इट डिपिक्ट्स, क्या शो करता है? I just want to harp upon you all. Apart from your studies,
yes,
yes, Pita.
Sir, it depicts that time is in a model, and this time is in a model. One needs to progress constantly.
Very good. Apart from this speech of 24 lines, just in brief, I will tell you something. It is very unique, and every day is a learning day. Rather, everyone should know, because these are the things which are in this country for the last 70 years, 7 decades. And 80% of the people do not know ki Ashok chakra kab hai, kya usme jo shade hai, bell hai, uska kya hai. उसमें जो चक्र है उसकी क्या सिग्निफिकेंस है? The founding fathers ने कितना विचार किया होगा, कितना दबाव लगाया होगा कि हमको यहाँ क्या फेस करना है? By just in three times that is everything. Apart from this series, learn these things. They may be a question made for to you whenever you go in some interview. If you pass out card yes, they may be a question. Not only related to law, but these general knowledge questions is also part of law. Constitution, Ashok Chakra stump, these may be questions may be posed to you, so one should be ready. Or many of these are because of Ashok Chakra ka letter tha, visiting card tha, lekin jab maine profession just bana, उस उसमें जो मैंने इस समय गुजारा भी किया और मैं ब्रीफ आपको बताऊं बिकॉज दीज आर थिंग्स वी शुड नो. अशोक स्तंभ की खासियत क्या है? चार सिंह हमारी शक्ति साहस गर्व और आत्मविश्वास का प्रतीक है. चतुर्दिक मुख ये सिंह सभी दिशाओं की सतर्कता एकता का संकेत देते हैं. बैल स्तंभ के पश्चिम दिशा में स्थित बलशाली बैल राष्ट्र की ताकत का द्योतक है. ये बड़ी मेहनत और दृढ़ता का प्रतीक करता है. स्तंभ में दाईं ओर स्थित है. दिस इज बैल. धर्म चक्रों के बीच मौजूद एक शेर उत्तर दिशा में स्थित है. यह चिन्ह वीरता और गौरव का प्रतीक है. चौथे शेर के नीचे स्थित है. इसके प्रतीक में दिखाई नहीं देता, आपको तीन दिखाई देते हैं हमेशा. पीछे चौथा भी है. हाथी पूर्व दिशा में स्थित यह हाथी शक्ति दृढ़ता और परिश्रम दर्शाता है. शेर की तरह यानी पीछे की ओर होने के कारण राष्ट्रीय प्रतीक में दिखाई नहीं देता. घोड़ा यह दक्षिण दिशा में स्थित है. चौकड़ी घसा ये घोड़ा संघर्ष के बीच हमारी रफ्तार को बयान करता है. ये वफादारी गति और ऊर्जा का प्रतीक माना जाता है. धर्म चक्र में चारों दिशाओं में बने हैं. ये न्याय सम्मान और अधिकारों का प्रतीक है. इसकी 24 तीलियां ये सभी एक बच्चे ने बताया 24 घंटों को दर्शाता है. 24 घंटे आपके जो दिन के होते हैं उसका प्रतिनिधित्व करता है. मेरा ये कहना है कि अशोक चक्र जो आपको हर जगह देखा होगा, हर फंक्शन में देखा होगा, पॉलिटिकल और गवर्नमेंट फंक्शन होते हैं वहां देखा होगा, उसका यू शुड बी नोइंग द निकेटिव्स ऑफ व्हाट इज देयर इन आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. अशोक चक्र जनगण मन में क्या है क्या नहीं है. जनगण मन अपन गा देते हैं लेकिन उसकी जो निकेटिव्स हैं वो अपने को भी शुड बी नोइंग. फ्रेंड्स बहुत तो नहीं लेकिन मैं ये कहना चाहूंगा कि एटमॉस्फेयर विच इज गिवन बाय यू बाय योर पेरेंट्स बाय योर टीचर्स गैदर एवरीथिंग जितना ज्यादा अच्छी तरह से सपोर्ट करो. दिस डेज इज नॉट सम योर फ्यूचर ऑफ द कंट्री. आफ्टर पासिंग आउट यू आर वेलकम टू ज्वाइन द प्रोफेशन. And I would request all my students that you will join in the global profession, keeping in mind that you have to come on the litigation side. This is my personal feeling. While I comment students coming out of 5-year course that they are doing exceedingly well, but this is a sorry state of figures. That 60% or 70% of the students are not entering the litigation side. What are some reasons? I am feeling they go to the MNCs or large corporations and are happy with whatever they gave, they have been given, they are paid hefty amounts. But the thing which they should give to the society, they are not giving. My request and suggestion that you, whenever you pass out, join the litigation side. Or there are several avenues. Especially, this is my experience in the last about 8 years, and this is Montasar is here. Especially, 2/3 of the judges being selected in the lower cadre are females. A new avenue has been created, a new atmosphere is coming up. The 2/3 of the judges being selected in RJS are females. And that is a very happy sign. Maybe in another 10 years, majority of the judges residing in the lower courts and then naturally they will, when elevated in the airport, would be females residing. And that would be a very happy sign that the country is going in the right direction. So that way, you can serve the society by giving RTS exams. And the day you are selected, you are imparting the divine duties which God has given you. Kadi mehnat, yaar, kadi na haarna. And then I will close by the three D's and three E's. Dedication, devotion, discipline. These are the three rules of the life. And ethics, excellence, and education. Remember these three D's and E's. Dedication, discipline, devotion. Excellence, ethics, and education. These things, if you imbibe, you will certainly rise to great occasions. And lastly, don't forget your teachers, Ma, Mahatma, Paramatma. In thing ko hamesha yaad rakhiye. Ma, the teachers bhi aate hain. धन्यवाद माँ ही आपका टीचर ही आपका माँ का रूप है चाहे की और चाहे शी हो और महात्मा और परमात्मा महात्मा असली वाले आज के महात्मा नहीं जो बिल्कुल आप टीवी में देखते हैं और अखबारों में देखते हैं जिसको भी आपको विश्वास हो उस महात्मा पे और परमात्मा से रहिए we are none except one who is above everyone. God bless you all, and I would request all to succeed. जो भी ना आए हैं, they can endeavor that you will succeed. Of course, success winner would be one. But एक छोटा से मजाकिया शब्द है. For winner, the romance would end on, I think, third February. The winner of the romance will keep going until the end. But the runner of the romance will continue for the next year. So, that's what we can do. Let the romance of some day come to an end on third. But the asli romance will be solved by next year. The next year will be moved forward. So the way it's solved, the runner will have also the romance. अच्छा लगेगा क्योंकि शादी होते ही तो रोमांस खत्म हो जाता है और बाकी रोमांस तो जब आधे अधूरे होते हैं यंग होते हैं वो रोमांस तो हमेशा याद रहता है कि हाँ तो थैंक यू कतरा साहब हाँ मौका मिलता है कि बच्चों का फंक्शन है प्रोग्राम है इवन एट अ शॉर्ट नोटिस आई नेवर रिफ्यूज बिकॉज़ व्हेनेवर आई एम अमंगस्ट द स्टूडेंट्स आई फील यंग आई मायसेल्फ फील एनर्जाइज्ड सो गॉड ब्लेस यू ऑल जय हिंद जय भारत